Welcome everyone. Now here we have some assignment from a CASNEB adapted paper, that is CIFA examinations. And the question states, the table below shows the distribution of salaries of medical employees in two counties, P and Q, that is P and Q, in thousands of shillings. So actually we have been given the salaries in terms of groups. Then per each, the salary for each country, that is the number of frequency, like group of 94 to 98. We have a total of 20 employees paid under that bracket of salary. And then you're required to determine the mean medical salary of each county. Now, we are only going to concentrate on the first county, after which you'll be able to employ the same notion, the same calculation to work out the mean salary for county Q. That will be your assignment now. Now, this is a special type of grouped data. And for the case of a grouped data, I want us to use what is known as the direct method. So under this particular direct method, we are going to incorporate in what is known as the midpoint. The midpoint here refers to the middle figures or the middle numbers at the center of each class or each group. And why are we using the midpoint M in this case? It is because midpoint is actually a true approximation. It is a true approximation of mean, because actually we assume that even if you are given, for example, only this particular data from 98 to 102, we assume that the mean, which is the value that appears at the middle of a particular data, will be found at the center. So when you use the direct method, we normally use this formula here, x bar standing for mean. And for us to get x bar, which is the mean, we normally divide the summation of fx, this is lambda, summation of x fm divided by n. Of course, f here refers to the number of occurrence or the frequency. Like in this case, the frequency for 94 to 98 is 20 times. Then n here refers to the number of frequency. The number of frequency. So we are going to add all this and get an n value below here. So that is actually how we are going to do this particular work. So let us first of all start by getting the middle values, which is actually 94 plus 98 divided by 2 to get the middle, which is 96. It's actually 96. So 98 plus 1 plus 102 divided by 2 should be 100. That should be 100. And then we have 102 plus 106 should divide by 2 should be 104. 104. 106 plus 110 divided by 2 should be 108. 110 plus 114 divided by 2 should be 112. Then this plus this divided by 2 should be 116. 118 plus 122 divided by 2 should be 120. Then finally we have this plus this divided by 2 is supposed to be 124. Then we get fx, that is fm, sorry. Fm simply refers to this one times this one. So 96 times 20 should be 6 times 20. It's supposed to have 19. 20. 100 times 50 should be 5000. We have 104. 4 times 104 times 120. We should have a value of 12,480. We have 108 times 170. We have 18,360. 12 times 140. You're 15,680. Then you have 116 times 60. What we get is 6,960. 120 times 30 supposed to be 3,600. Then 124 times 10 is supposed to be 1,240. Okay. Then we get the summation of n and summation of x, fm. So actually, when you add all these, it's supposed to be 70 plus 120. So 70 plus 120 is supposed to be 190 plus 170 is supposed to be 190 plus 170 is supposed to be 190 plus 170 is supposed to be 360 plus 140 plus 200. So 360 plus 240, for example. 240 plus the answer is supposed to be 600. So here we have 600. Then we have this one here, summation of x, fm. 1920 plus 500 plus 15 480 plus 18 360 plus 15 680 plus 6960 plus 3,640. We get a value of 63,740. So of course, for us to get our mean, we divide mean. It is the summation of fm divided by n, which is the number of frequencies. It's supposed to be 63,740 divided by 600. We get a value of, so divide by 600, get a value of 106.2333. So we approximate. So actually our arithmetic mean salary is it was in terms of 1,000, so we multiply by 1,000 shillings. So times 1,000 shillings is supposed to have 106,203.333 shillings. Thank you.